Counselors, please.
It is simple. The Empire has the means of mass destruction. The Rebellion does not.
Welcome, everyone. This is Master's Joke. Also, Master's Joke 75 on Instagram. So today, I'm going to be opening up my Senator Mon Mothma from Andor, my favourite Disney Plus Star Wars series. I think it's just great. Look, really looking forward to Series 2 in 2025. And this is one of the figures that I picked up from Lame during its final week, 50% off, closing down sale. Let your eyes be your guide, £7.50. And, you know, I've mentioned it many times. I've been trying to step back from the Black Series. This is like an old release because it's a windowless box. But I really like her. Mon Mothma, always have done since Return of the Jedi, and for £7.50, I couldn't say no. So, you know, if you'd watched the video, I also picked up Vale as well, great figure, and I've got Andor in the Imperial uniform, which I bought from Lame ages ago for I think I paid a tenner. I know he went down to a fiver, but that was probably a couple of years ago I bought that figure. But I think it was a really, really good deal. Really looking forward to opening her up, as well as my Mandalorian N1 Starfighter, which my wife got me, which, honestly, I'm still blown away by this, as well as Jabba the Hutt, a new release, like a brand new released Star Wars action figure set on the Master's Joke channel. That's unbelievable. And she paid full price. I think she got it from Hasbro Pulse. So, well happy to be opening that up very, very soon. But I wanted to get Mon out of the way because, I've opened up the Vale figure. So I thought, you know, it'd be good to just get this open. Then I can put the box in the loft. But, there's a bit of detail about her on the back. Not much. In an era filled with danger, deception and intrigue, Cassian Andor embarks on a path that will turn him into the rebel hero who will challenge the evil galactic empire. But it's got nothing about the Mon on there. I don't understand why it doesn't actually say anything about Mon Mothma whatsoever. And remember that she was also, well, obviously she was in Return of the Jedi, but this actress, she also appeared in Rogue One, and she's also in Ahsoka as well. She does make an appearance in Ahsoka. So yeah, very, very strange. Well, I've not even mentioned her on the back of the packaging, but you know, this packaging is all in the past. Not sure. I mean, this is one again. This is one of the reasons why I have stepped back. I'm not sure if this figure would have been worth £29.99. £15 is not a bad price, but £7.50 is even better. And it's got a lovely image on the side there as well. So I'm going to get this opened up. And there's only one way to open these Black Series figures, and that is from the bottom of the box. So I'm going to do that now. So yeah, when I was opening Vel, I honestly thought that the box was empty because it was so light. But there is not much weight, but there is weight to this box. So you can actually tell that there is a figure in there. So let's let's get her out. And similar to the Vintage Collection 4-pack, you know, the 4-pack boxes, which are great for army building, and they say, you know, it saves the planet. They're now the same price as if you were buying 4 figures on cards. So it's just ridiculous. But I'm not sure I like the way that she's been mummified in the box. And there's a lot of wasted space. And if they are trying to save the planet, why is the box so big? But what I'm going to do, she just slides out. So that was quite easy enough. I do like the way it does say Star Wars Black Series on the tissue paper. Wow, yeah, she does have a bit of weight to her, so So if we have a look at the figure, that is a really, really nice figure. The facial sculpt of the actress, that is amazing. That really is amazing. I'm really, really impressed. And the hair as well, and the skin tone. They have done an amazing job on her facial sculpt and her head. It really does look good. So there's no soft goods on the figure. The articulation is all right. It's the design, isn't it? But the kind of joints are quite noticeable. But it's the actual design of the figure, I suppose. I look at her feet. I thought her shoe was coming off there. Trying to get it into focus there. It looks like her high heels are coming off. But that's her foot, very bent. Yeah, it's an unusual figure. Nice paint applications on the chain, on her front. Nice, but it's nice. It is nice detail. There's not a lot you can say. I mean, it's you know, she's wearing a beige outfit, but it does look nice, and the hands are good. I don't believe it comes with any accessories. I don't think she comes with any accessories whatsoever. They could have given her something. Yeah, the articulation on the hands are quite good. It looks like she's got the kind of hand to hold a gun. I suppose the Mon, she's all about peace, isn't she? That's why she hasn't got a weapon. That's a nice touch, I think, on the front of the skirt. That's quite detailed there. But yeah, do you know what? I mean, for a Black Series figure, I'm a little bit, I mean, I'm not disappointed. I paid £7.50. I do like the character, but I'm a bit disappointed that there's absolutely no soft goods on this figure whatsoever, because they could have at least done soft goods down the bottom of the skirt, or even just this piece here, but there's absolutely no soft goods on her at all. It's a good figure, but they could have done so much more, I think. I like the gold applications around the sleeves. I'm not sure about this figure. It's one of those ones where, a bit like the Emperor from the original line, apart from the fact that she doesn't wear flares, but you've got to have her hands in a certain way for the actual outfit to work. So yeah, no, see, it's a good figure, but it doesn't really do much. I don't know. What I'm going to do, because her foot is a little bit bent, I'm going to straighten her all out, have a proper look in the packet, make sure there's nothing else that I'm missing, and set her up. Right, so I got the Mon all set up. It's a good figure. It's a great likeness. It's a good sculpt. It is what it is. I mean, it's based on the character in the story. I am really impressed by the head sculpt, because it looks so much like the actress. Disappointed that it doesn't have any accessories. Now, I'm trying to think what accessory you could have. I mean, there must have been... Didn't she have a bag? I'm sure she had a bag in one of the episodes of Andor. I'm trying to remember. I need to watch that series again. When she was visiting, you know, the guy, I can't remember the guy's name, but the guy who's looking after Andor, who owns the antique shop, I'm sure she had a bag. They could have given you something. So 0 points for no accessories. It's a good figure, but it doesn't blow you away, because it's very difficult. I mean, it's very difficult to get blown away by this figure, because it's not her best outfit. I mean, she's got better outfits than this. But it does look like her, you know. I mean, you can't fault it for that. Yeah, I am. I'm a bit underwhelmed, but I'm, you know, for £7.50, let your eyes be your guide. For the price point, it's very difficult. It's very difficult to rate a figure that you don't really, that doesn't look that great. But it's nothing to do with what Hasbro have done. It's more to do with, it's just the Mons outfit. It's not the best outfit, and it's very bland, and it's very beige. But apart from that, Hasbro have done a really good job. You couldn't have this line without the Mon. I mean, you need Mon Mothma to kind of complete the set, and the Andor figures, they are really good. And you know, I've realised now that I have actually picked up quite a few of the Andor figures from Lame over the last year or so at really, really reasonable prices that I still need to open. So for what it is, I mean, the paint applications, the articulation, I mean, you know, there's articulation under the skirt, but we're not even going to go there. The articulation's all right on the arms and the head. So you've got to base it on what it is. I like the figure. I'm glad I picked it up. No, I'm not disappointed. I'm a bit underwhelmed. They've done a good job. They should have done some soft goods around the skirt, even if it's just at the bottom here or on this this piece here. I mean, this piece is quite nice, but they should have done some kind of soft goods on it. So for that reason, soft goods would have made this figure a little bit more exciting. A bit like Morgan Elsbeth. I mean, I've only got Morgan Elsbeth in the retro and also the vintage collection. But the vintage collection does have a bit of soft goods on there, so they should have done something with this. So do you know what? I'm going to give it 8 out of 10. Because it's a bit underwhelming, but it's, you need it. You need it in the set. But yeah, £7.50. Let your eyes be your guide, but you know, I wouldn't have wanted to pay more than £7.50. I've got to be honest, and I've got the old gang out as well, the old Shore Trooper, and you can still pick these up in Lame, and Andor himself. This is just an amazing figure, and I was talking to a guy at Collectomania. I was looking at the vintage collection version, and I know the vintage collection version has the Shore Trooper boots, which is it's not ideal, but I think the figure looks really good, so I'd like to pick up this figure in the vintage collection, definitely. And of course, you've got Vel as well. And also, I looked after I made the Vel video in relation to the gun. I had a look on YouTube, and the end of the gun does pull out. It does pull out, but I just cannot get it out. And I'm not going to pull it any further because I don't want to break it. So that is a shame about Vel's gun. But if anyone's got any tips on Vel's gun, how to get the actual this part of the, you know, of the machine gun out, just drop me a line in the comments, because I really kind of give up on it. But yeah, a little bit underwhelmed, if I'm honest. I thought it would be a little bit better than that. I don't think she is available in the vintage collection. Although the Mon Mothma from the Return of the Jedi wave in the retro collection, obviously it was a figure we never got. That blew me away. That really blew me away. And I'm sure, did she have an accessory? I'm sure she's got a Princess Leia gun. I'm sure she's got a Princess Leia gun. So that's what it was about. The original line was about adventures. You didn't have to stick to the script. So Hasbro should have done something. So, you know, if they're not giving accessories, they need to give some kind of soft goods. So I'm really happy with the figure, 8 out of 10. And it loses points purely because, it, you know, for a figure that bland, it should have some soft goods, just to make it a little bit more exciting, and some kind of accessory. But I'm happy with it. £7.50. Let your eyes be your guide. Lame in St. Evenage. Rest in peace. The new store should be open by now. I've not popped in there because I wanted to see what I got for my birthday first. And also, I've got to be mindful of the cash to splash, because I'm still hoping to go to the NEC. Hoping. It's not definite yet. I'd like to go to the NEC. But that is the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for Jabba the Hutt being opened, as well as my Mandalorian N1 Starfighter, or I call it a Naboo Starfighter. I just think it looks absolutely amazing. I can't believe I've got it on my list. I did to my wife, I mentioned, because initially I was going to mention Star Action figures, because they had a 20% on certain items. They're 20% off because they were doing that warehouse move. So you could get the Naboo Starfighter for like 80. And then they changed it to 10%. But I suggested Comics and Cocktails, where it was £79.99. I know it's been out for ages, but it's beautiful, absolutely beautiful. So yeah, stay tuned for that. And Jabba the Hutt, I still can't believe that, you know, I'll be opening up a... recent release on the Bastards Joke channel, but no one's going to watch it because everyone's doing their reviews. Whereas when I did the Endor Bunker, because I got it over a year after it had been released, I don't know why, but people watched it, like more people than usual. So I don't know, but yeah, I'll be opening Jabba. Maybe compare them to the original. But yeah, that's the end of the video, and I'll see you in the next one.